Good evening to all of you. Today we are going to study about the constructors and destructors in C++. In our last session we have seen static data members, static member function and friend functions in C++. So our today's topic is constructors and destructors. Now what do you mean by a constructor in C++? Constructor is a special member function whose task is to initialize the data members of the class, object of the class. Okay. Before constructor programming, we used the input function to read the values of the fields of the object. So constructor is the alternative method for the input method that we used. In our previous lectures, we have used the function like input, get data, read, etc. to read the values inside the object of the class. So today we are going to study about the alternate method to read the object values, that is called as constructor. A constructor is a special member function whose task is to initialize the objects of the class. It is special because its name is same as that of the class name. The constructor is invoked whenever an object of its associated class is created. It is called constructor because it constructs the values of the data members of the class. Now what it means? Constructor is special because the name of the constructor method is same as that of the class. Its task is to initialize the object of the class. Third point is, it gets automatically invoked by the compiler whenever you create the object of its own class. So there is no need to call the constructor method like a normal member function input and get data in previous programs that we have seen. We need to call that methods through the object. So in constructors, we need not have to call the constructor methods. Now how to write a constructor? This question may comes to your mind. So this is the example given here about us designing of a constructor. See, in example, class integer, there are two variables m and n in the private area. In the public area, we need to take a function which reads the values of m and n, right? So instead of using a normal member function, we can use a constructor like this. Integer in bracket void semicolon. It is just declared like a normal function the way we declared before. And it is defined outside the class like this. This is the construct class name, scope operation operator, constructor name, and we have assigned the values m and n to 0. Now whenever you create an object in the main program like this with the line integer int 1, it not only creates the object integer int 1 but also initializes the values 0 to m and n variable of that particular object. So this is one of the default type of constructor which assigns default values to the constructor. A constructor that accepts no parameters is called default constructor. The default constructor for class A is written like this: A scope operation operator and A in bracket. So name of the constructor method is same as that of the class. If no such constructor is defined in the class, then the compiler supplies a default constructor. Therefore a statement such as A small a, so A is the class name and small a is the object here, invokes the default constructor of the compiler to create the object small a in this case. Now we must remember the characteristics, special characteristics of the constructor function. First important property is they should be declared in the public section of the class always. Second is they are invoked automatically when the objects are created. It means that we cannot call constructor functions. They are automatically invoked by the compiler whenever you create the object of the class. They do not have return type. This is very, very important characteristics. They do not have any return type, not even void, and therefore they cannot return any values to the caller. Fourth property is they cannot be inherited. Though a derived class can call the base class constructor. Like other C++ functions, they can have default arguments. Constructor cannot be virtual. We cannot refer to their addresses. Like call by reference is not possible with constructor method. Any object with constructor cannot be used as a member of a union. They make implicit calls to the constructor, to the operators new and delete when memory allocation is required. That is, dynamic memory allocation is required. So you have to remember at least 4 to 5 important properties of the constructor, and that you have to write into the exam. Now we'll see another type of constructor. So there are 3 different types of constructor that we have in C++. The first one is default constructor. The constructor which does not take a parameter is called default constructor. Okay, Pankaj wants to ask a question to me. So I'll transfer a control to him so that he can ask. Hello Pankaj. Any question that you want to ask? Hello. Scroll upward, okay. Here. Or okay, before the previous slide. Here, this example. Okay. Any problem in this? No. It does not have return type always. Constructor do not have any return type. Here in this example also, if you see, when the constructor was defined outside the class, there were no return type written before the name of the class, correct? Directly class name, scope register operator, and then constructor method. Is it okay now? Shall we go ahead? Hello, Florin. Hi, Florin. Any question? Previous slide. Yes. The name which is written into the bold letters, integer here. After this scope operation operator, correct, we write the function name, that and constructor is also a function in C++. But it is special because the name of the constructor method is same as that of the class name. Right? Okay, I am unmuting your microphone now, and we'll move to the next topic, that is second type of constructor, that is parameterized constructor. What do you mean by a parameterized constructor? A name suggests, as the name indicates, the constructor which takes the parameters is called parameterized constructors. So this is a little bit modified version of the default constructor. Here if you see, again, the class name is constructor. There are 2 variables m and n, and there is a constructor which takes parameters in the bracket, if you see, integer x comma integer y. So this is a constructor which takes 2 parameters. It assigns x value to m and n y value to n later on. If you see in the definition of the constructor function outside the class, m has assigned x and n has assigned y. So whenever you create an object like this into the main program, integer int 1, this line will not work now, because this constructor requires parameters. In previous example, that was a default constructor, so no need to pass a parameter, and that line worked properly. Here this line will not work. We must pass the initial values as argument to the constructor function when an object is declared. Now this can be done by 2 methods, by calling the constructor explicitly or by calling the constructor implicitly. Now, what do you mean by calling the constructor explicitly? Whenever the line like this comes into your code, it means it is an explicit call to the constructor method. It means how to create the object in explicit call. We write class name, then the object name, then equal to sign, and then on the right hand side, we call the constructor method and we pass the required parameters by the constructor. So this constructor required two parameters, so we passed two values here in the bracket. So this type of calling a constructor is called an explicit call. There is another method by which we can call a constructor, that is called implicit call. So we can do like this: integer int 1, immediately after the object name, we can write the values that are required by the constructor method. So in this example, 0 will be assigned to M and 100 will be assigned to N. So a parameterized constructor means a constructor which takes parameters is called parameterized constructor. A question may be asked in the examination: can a constructor be overloaded? Can a constructor be overloaded? Yes, because a function which takes parameters can be overloaded. So constructor can also be overloaded. We can have all the three types of constructor in the same program of C++. That may be a default constructor, parameterized constructor, and the third type of constructor is called as copy constructor. That we are going to see here later. Now we'll see the first example using a constructor program, constructor function. See this class, which has two variables m and n. Then there is a constructor in the public area. Remember one thing: always the constructor must be declared or defined in public area only. Like this, display function is responsible for displaying the values of m and n variable here. Now this constructor method is defined outside the class. As we know, constructor do not have any return type, so there is no return type mentioned here before the class name. So this is the class name, then scope return operator, and this is actually the coding of the constructor method, where m is assigned x and n is assigned y. In the main program, when you go, we need to first of all create the object of this class. So the first object integer 1 is created like this, and this is nothing but the implicit calling, right, to the constructor method. So immediately after the object name, in the parenthesis, if you provide any values, it means it is an implicit call to the constructor method. So this line not only creates object int 1 but also assigns the values 0 and 100 to m and n respectively. In the second line, where we create the second object integer int 2, here the explicit call goes to the constructor function, and the values 25 and 75 will be assigned to m and n variables respectively. So the object 1, integer 1, has the value 0 and 100. Object 2, integer 2, has the values 25 and 75 in it. Now if I want to display the values of this object, I need to call the function display through the object. Integer int 1 dot display will display the values of the first object, and this line, that is integer 2 dot display, will going to display the values of the second object. So in the output, if you see, it will show you the value inside the first object is 0 and 100. In next object, that is object 2, we have values m equal to 25 and n equal to 75. Okay, so this is the example on constructor and the parameterized constructor. Now we'll see the third type of constructor, that is called as copy constructor. A constructor which takes the object as a parameter is called copy constructor here. So this is a small example of a third category of constructor, that is copy constructor. Here the class name is A, and in the public area we have written a constructive method or a function like this.